صلى الله على نبيه الكريم سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ربنا وآتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد.
Dear brothers and sisters, it's unbelievable that we fasted already 5 days of Ramadan. How quick it is, and that's like our lives. It is running like that. And if we don't follow what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in the hadith, يَغْتَنِمْ خَمْسًا قَبْلَ خَمْسٍ, take the opportunity of five before five. And one of them is hayatata qabla mamatik, your life before your death. And the life is very short, especially nowadays. People are dying like flies. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala had told us in the Quran, one of the purposes or the outcome that we aim from this fasting, when Allah said, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So the purpose of Ramadan, or fasting Ramadan, is that so we can prosper, we can be pious, we can fear Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And Allah said in the Quran about taqwa, وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُتَّقُونَ. Oh, he said in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Oh, you who believe, oh, you who believe, don't die unless you are on the status of Islam. And that is one of the purposes of fasting Ramadan, that so we will not die unless we are on the status of Islam. And taqwa, purpose, or fearing Allah, purpose is for dunya and for akhirah. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said in the Quran as well, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهُ. One of the most important ways to get the knowledge of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is to fear Him. And the best way to fear Him is to fast Ramadan, as He told you, so you can get to that outcome, you can get to that result. And when you get that result, that means you are prepared to have the knowledge of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, to put it in your heart. Dear brothers and sisters, this is the month of Quran. The ulama, when Ramadan comes, they close all the other books and open only the book of Quran, and they start reading it and studying it. Therefore, they said that every Muslim has to read Quran at least once in his life, the entire Quran. And I'm talking here to those who don't understand Arabic. Ramadan is an opportunity for all of us who don't understand Arabic at least to hear Quran from their ears. Somebody might say, what is the purpose for me to listen to something I don't understand? Here is a story, a very useful story. Very short one, but very useful. An old man who was teaching his grandson Quran. They are not from the Arabic background and they don't understand Arabic. This boy told his granddad, why you are teaching me something I don't understand and I won't understand? And it is not stuck on me, I can't memorize it because I don't understand it. The old man wanted to teach his grandson a lesson. He gave him a bucket which has a big hole inside it. He told him, go to the river and bring me a water to fill another bucket beside him. The boy told him, how can I fill a bucket with a bucket which has a hole, it cannot hold water. He told him, give it a try, my son. The boy went to the river, and every time he takes the water, he comes, as he reached to his granddad, there is no water in the bucket, obviously, because it has a hole. The boy was frustrated, but his dad, his granddad kept telling him, give it a try, give it a try. After several times, the boy came. His granddad told him, look, now you couldn't fill this bucket, but look at the bucket I gave you. What is the difference between when I gave it to you and right now? The boy looked inside the bucket and he saw that the bucket is very clean. He told him the difference, that it's very clean. He told him, likewise, this Quran, you don't understand it, but when he goes inside you, when it goes inside your heart, it cleans your heart. It cleans your heart, even though you don't understand it. But you can read it with your language, any language you want. It is translated, because it is very important if you know that this is the book that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala had revealed to you. And he told us in the fourth rak'ah when Imam read to us from Surah Al-Ma'idah, he told us, قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ. Indeed, a book from Allah, a light, has come to you, نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ, a book which is very clear. يَهْدِي بِهِ اللَّهُ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ رِضْوَانَهُ يَهْدِي بِهِ اللَّهُ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ رِضْوَانَهُ سُبُلَ السَّلَامِ وَيُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. Allah will guide those one who follow this book, the ways of peace. وَيُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ, and he takes them from dark, from darkness to light. So it is a book that for guiding us, for taking us from darkness to the light. And no better time than reading this book in Ramadan, brothers and sisters, as I said in the last time in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, al-halb al-muntahin, the man that reads Quran from the beginning till the end, and he keep going doing that. Those are the people of Allah. Those are the people who will be protected, because Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. Those who fear Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah will find for them always ways from their difficulties. وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ, and he give you sustenance from the ways or from the doors that you are not expecting. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولجميع المسلمين واستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.